Welcome to the Not So Big Show, the Arizona Wildcat Show, brought to you by Fry's Food Stores. I'm Star Sports Editor Ryan Finley, here with Zack Rosenblatt. Zack, the last time I saw you, you were
dumping ice water on me.
I was dumping ice water on you. You were freezing, all for charity. Talk about the Chillin' for Charity Challenge and what has happened in the 2 weeks since we dumped a trash can full of ice water on your head.
I'm still cold from that, Dennis. Well, no, I mean, I said it spread like wildfire then, even more so now. It's gone to, like, Rich Rod did it, and he challenged a few other high school college coaches. Greg Byrne did it. He challenged a bunch of ADs. Todd Holthouse, the Pima women's basketball coach, did it. There were some sports center anchors that did it. It's just really, Nia Butts is killing it on that thing, and she's retweeting everybody that's doing it, just all of women's basketball especially, but it spread to other sports and other college athletics and other avenues of media and stuff like that. It's so cool how she's been able to do that.
Yeah, and this is something Nia Butts came up with, right? I mean, this was kind of her idea.
Yeah, well, because like there's the whole cold water challenge that's become a big thing now, and her assistant coach thought it would be fun just to do that with the other coaches, and then Nia Butts is like, they're more likely to do it if we attach charity to it. So it's worked out pretty well. I'm sure they're making a lot of money. I don't know what the number is, but they've made some money on that.
Right. All proceeds go to the Kay Yao Fund, named after the longtime women's basketball coach who died of cancer. For Nia Butts, Zack, there hasn't been a whole lot of good news coming out of camp this off season. She is certainly on the hot seat going forward. What does this do for kind of her perception nationwide and within the conference?
Well, it's certainly given her a name nationwide, because she's the root of this and it's spreading everywhere. So I would think in recruiting it would help maybe, where people know her name now and she's getting her name out there. Maybe it's not a focus on the women's basketball team in particular, which might be good because they went 5-25 last year. So nobody wants to talk about that right now. And they're kind of trying to move on from that. And this is certainly a good step in that direction.
Sure. This is the Arizona Wildcat Show, brought to you by Fry's Food Stores. Ryan Finley here with Zack Rosenblatt. Zack, let's talk about Nia Butts here for a minute. She's somebody who we've all gotten to know kind of over the years. I'm hard-pressed to find a person in McHale Center, in the media, or among the fan base who doesn't like her as a person.
Yeah.
But there's been some real problems with turnover. Why do you think that is?
A lot of it has to do with, I think, they haven't had much success. And I don't know, last year was just everything that could go wrong did go wrong. There were ACL injuries, people leaving the team for personal reasons. By the end of the year, they only had 7 healthy players, which is just insane, just 2 bench players. So everybody was getting starters minutes. They have double the amount of players coming in next year. It's almost all a new roster, just transfers and freshmen, and people are going to have to play right away. Their top freshman, though, might not even play this year, which Taryn Griffey, who missed both her junior and senior years of high school to knee injuries, which obviously is concerning.
But she was their best recruit, and she hadn't played since her sophomore year in high school?
I guess she was pretty good her first 2 years, and then she obviously has the pedigree and, I guess, the skill set. And then right before the season, each time, it just happened again and again. And she was in the top 100 or top 75, wherever they do on ESPN for the rankings. So she's pretty highly touted, and she's supposed to be athletic and supposed to be the point guard of the future, but who knows what will happen when she comes back.
What do you think Nia Butts is going to have to do in terms of real success to get off of this hot seat that she's found herself on heading into, you know, the fall and the winter?
I think it's all about recruiting. She's got to get the right girls in there, talented. The Pac-12 is a pretty good conference in basketball, and they need to be competitive. I mean, they haven't made an NCAA tournament in her entire tenure, and it's been a while since they have made it. So I think it's all about getting players here and then keeping them here and developing them. Because if they're leaving after a year or two, then they're not going to develop. A few years ago, they signed a girl who was 6'4". Her name was Allie Rohde. Yeah. She was like the next great thing here, and then she left after her freshman year. So like you got to keep players like that here if you want to be competitive in this conference.
And Allie Rohde, it wasn't that she left. It was that she left for what seemed to me like a lateral move at best, right?
Yeah, she went to UNLV, I'm pretty sure.
Right. That's crazy. Well, you know, winning some games, when we talk about what Nia Butts needs to do, it's not recruiting, it's not developing players, it's improving on the 5 win total from last year, because if she can do that, I think she'll be fine. If not, there's going to be another coach sort of reaping the rewards of whatever recruiting success she has.
And if you don't improve on 5 wins, then maybe you shouldn't have the job anymore anyway.
That's a good point. For a dry and pretty happy Zack Rosenblatt, I'm Ryan Finley. This is the Arizona Wildcat Show, brought to you by Fry's Food Stores. We'll see you next time.
Try this matchup. Low prices and faster checkout. You can count on it at Fry's.